I'm 55 years old. I've raised three amazing kids. I built a beautiful business. I've had a great life. I'm blessed with for being a two-time stage four cancer survivor. I have an autoimmune disease that the doctors told me I have 5 years to live. Life has blessed me with many, what people would say, hardships. I call them blessings because the story's not over. And every little hardship that they say can turn into an amazing victory that can solidify your soul even stronger, that you can touch other people with your new story. This is just an acceptance of the situation, a lot of gratitude, and this is the outcome from it.
Hi, it's Ro from Gratitude, and we're all coming up to the holidays, and we all want to be able to be with family and friends in the holiday season, but the challenge that every one of us is facing is that we're constantly surrounded by stress. You know, this thing that we call the human brain has evolved to keep us safe, and it literally has been programmed to notice where we're not, to notice what's wrong. You know, everywhere we look, we're going to be able to see what's wrong. There's always someone who's going to piss us off or some personal or business challenge that's stressing us out. And life, I mean, it just doesn't always go as it should. There's always something to be worried or stressed about. And I'm here to invite you that with a little bit of gratitude, we can also start to expose and to appreciate what's right. I believe and I teach that gratitude is the antidote to stress. Look, life is not monochromatic. It's filled with a myriad of emotions. But if there are a couple emotions that many of us sink into that have the potential of derailing our happiness, it's fear and anger. I want you to enact the power of gratitude this holiday season and forever. I want you to take the time each morning, each afternoon, and each evening to count your blessings. This simple practice will begin to rewire, to strengthen your mind, to be able to look for what's right, to strengthen and condition the mind to appreciate the little things. I invite you to create a daily practice to focus on all the blessings, the people, and the experiences in your life, and to join me in a battle against fear and anger with the light and love of gratitude. On behalf of all who call gratitude home, I want to wish you a happy and safe holiday season.